You guys keep asking me to share some of the tricks I use on Rapier and Musket, so that's what this video is all about. Instead of a comprehensive guide, this video is going to target some of the more obscure tricks and mechanics of both weapons. I know you guys have some tricks of your own that I don't know about, so make sure you share them in the comments. And if you like this kind of content, make sure to like and subscribe so I know to do more of it. So without further ado, let's get into it. By far the most common question I get is, why do you use a lightning gem? It's because of the tracers. If you look at these clips, you can see that lightning tracers don't linger in the air as long as the arcane void and ice tracers do. Tracers that linger in the air a long time are easier for other musket users to track and hunt you down. An ice gem can be a decent choice if you attack players impacted by Ice Gauntlet's ultimate chill debuff often. You can swap weapons to reload your musket instead of letting the reload animation play out and slow your movement. It won't make the musket reload any faster, but it lets you move freely to be evasive and use evade to avoid attacks. This is especially useful against other ranged users. Just make sure you use tactical reload once every 6 seconds to get a second shot off. Another question I get often is, how do you fire your second shot so fast? This one is fairly simple. You just keep holding the right mouse button when you dodge to reload and fire as soon as you are back on target. Since her camera is offset to the right of the musket and your bullets originate from the end of your musket, you need to take care when peeking from the left. As you can see, my bullets are already hitting the wall at this point. From the right, you can aim directly up against cover without issues. Again, since our camera is to the right of the musket, you need to adjust your aim in close quarters a little towards the right side of the character model. You'll get a feel for this at different distances with practice. When you do damage to a target, you can see them through cover and walls for a few seconds. However, if you apply a bleed from Keenly Jagged or a burn from Powder Burn, you can see them for the whole duration of the damage over time. This is extremely useful when you tag someone and they go behind cover. Crippling Powder Burn isn't just a slow, it also increases your damage by activating passives. The Kick 'em While They're Down passive in the Musket Tree adds 10% damage, and the 250 Dex passive adds 10% crit damage. In patch 1.1, an additional zoom level was added to Musket. Just scroll wheel up one more notch beyond the second zoom level to access it. The biggest benefit of this additional zoom level is that it has very low sensitivity. I am moving my mouse the same distance on my desk in both clips. Evading forward moves a short distance, while evading back moves you quite a bit further. If you're close to an opponent when you evade side to side, it will automatically loop around their model. Evade can cancel any animation, including Fleche. You can cancel out of a light or heavy attack into riposte, or even do combinations like this. If you have a stationary target, you can do some significant burst damage with a Fleche into the interruption backstab, followed by a momentum buffed light attack, and then evade into another momentum buffed light attack. If you stamina break yourself, use evade to get back to full faster so you can dodge again. Now let's talk about gear. I've always shown you guys what I'm using, but we haven't talked about my priorities or my ideal perks. For earrings, I'm searching for one that has dex or int, generic physical or elemental resist, and refreshing toast, plus either nimble or purifying toast. For rings, I'm searching for one that has dex or int, generic physical or elemental resist, and keen awareness plus leeching. For amulets, I'm searching for one that has dex or int, generic physical or elemental resist, and health plus empowered. For armor perks, this is my priority list. Crippling Powder Burn is my absolute top priority. Next, I want to have Sundering Riposte and Empowering Shooter Stance. If I can get pieces that have Resilient along with those perks, all the better, but I'll take those weapon perks over Resilient if I have to. For the other armor slots, I prioritize Resilient over the other weapon perks. But if I can get Resilient and the weapon perk, that's great. I've been asked why I prioritize resilience so much even though I wear light armor, and the answer is that I don't like getting two-tapped by other glass cannon muskets or one-shotted by bows. The combination of full or nearly full resilient, the Hale and Hardy town buff, and health on my amulet makes me a three-tap for muskets and requires a bow to land more shots on me than just a single heavy attack or penetrating shot to knock me down. Weapons can be tough to attain, and there are a lot of good perks. That said, my ideal musket would have Vicious or Enchanted, Keenly Jagged, and Keen. I think there are plenty of other viable options like Infamy, so don't take my word as gospel. My ideal rapier would have Vicious, Keenly Empowered, and Keen. Rogue is still a good perk, but it's now correctly only impacting back attacks, so that's why Vicious gets the nod. Overall, you guys might have different builds and priorities than I do, and I highly encourage you to experiment, check out other content creators, and find what works best for you. In closing, let me just say this video was a lot of work, so show me some love if you enjoyed it. Oh.